The wave equations for a conducting medium. Wave equations for a conducting medium. So generally conducting medium means sigma value is not equal to 0. There is some finite value for sigma. Then what we have to do is take the basic equations, and the procedure what we did for plane waves, uniform plane waves, same procedure follow. But there is a sigma term exists. Then the equations are like, look like this. Directly I am writing the equations here. Because for a plane wave, the equations are del square E is equal to mu epsilon dou square E by dou t square, sigma is equal to 0. But here sigma exists for conducting medium. The equation looks like this. Del square E is equal to mu epsilon dou square E by dou t square, this term same as plane waves only, plus mu sigma, the additional term is mu sigma dou E by dou t, only first order differential equation, differential term, here second order differential term, dou square E by dou t square, dou E by dou t. Mu epsilon, mu sigma. So like this you can easily remember the wave equation. The first term is same as plane wave only. The second term is, we will get a single differential, term. Similarly, del square H is equal to mu epsilon dou square H by dou t square plus mu sigma into dou h by dou t, mu sigma into dou h by dou t. So these are the wave equations for a conducting medium. So like this you can easily remember these two equations. The first term is same as plane wave only. The second term is mu sigma, because of sigma value exists. The first order differential term. Similarly, mu sigma, the first order differential term. So like this you can easily remember the wave equations for a conducting medium. Generally these wave equations are in differential form, that is dou square E by dou x square for plane waves, or if you consider for a conducting medium it is del square is equal to something, del square h is equal to something. If you solve these equations, the second order differential equations, directly you will get E and H. Those are nothing but solution to E and H. So directly you can write the E in terms of some equation, H in terms of some equation. Those are called solutions of electromagnetic equations. Generally, The solution to differential equations, second order, because these are second order differential equations, are used in the form of some magnitude, either E or H. Magnitude into real part of e power j omega t, where A is magnitude. Of course, this is a representation called time harmonic fields. Time harmonic fields or more specifically, you can represent E or H A into some cos omega t either plus or minus beta x. Suppose I am assuming here the wave is propagating in x direction. So the solution looks like this. E or H is equal to A cos omega t plus or minus beta x. Of course, this may be either sinusoidal also. This is a particular type of representation known as a time harmonic fields representation, whereas this representation is a sinusoidal time variation. One more important thing is here is, here it is either omega t plus or minus beta x. Suppose this is omega t minus beta x, the wave is said to be propagating in positive x direction. Omega t plus beta x, the wave is said to be propagating in negative x direction. This is very, very important. We will solve a problem based on this so that it is very clear to us. Problem is, the electric field in free space is given by E is equal to 50 cos 10 power 8 t plus beta x ay cap volt per meter. The first question is, find the direction of wave propagation. The solution to this question is, so if you observe the electric field E, 50 some magnitude into cos omega t plus beta x So omega t plus beta x means the wave is propagating in which direction? Minus x direction. So the wave is propagating along minus x direction. So this, if you consider this is positive x, y, z, this is so the wave is propagating like this. That is minus ax. The second question is, what is beta value? So beta is nothing but phase constant. So beta is equal to 2 pi by lambda, we know it very well. So this is also equal to 2 pi lambda, how I can write lambda? C by F, where C is free space velocity. So this is nothing but 2 pi F by C. 2 pi F is nothing but omega by C. Therefore beta is equal to, what is omega value? 10 power 8 by C value, free space velocity, 3 into 10 power 8 meter per second, so 1 by 3, 0.333 radian per meter. So beta is called phase constant or wave number. Beta is also called as phase constant or wave number also. So what is the unit? Radian per distance. So here radian per meter. The third question is, the time taken by the wave to travel a distance lambda by 2. What is the time? Is what? The time taken by the wave to travel a distance lambda by 2. Lambda by 2 is what? The solution to this problem is, generally the wave, what is the wavelength lambda? This is a full wavelength lambda. So T, time period T. So to travel a distance of lambda, it will take one period. So then to travel a distance of lambda by 2, how much it will take? Obviously T by 2. Obviously T by 2. So the time taken by the wave to travel a distance lambda by T is nothing but T by 2, where T is the period. Then how to calculate T? We know that omega is equal to 2 pi by T. 2 pi f, f is the fundamental frequency, f is equal to 1 by T. Substitute there, T value is 2 pi by omega. T is equal to 2 pi by omega. And T by 2 is equal to into 1 by 2. Pi by omega. Omega we know already. Pi by 10 power 8. So we will get 31.42 nanoseconds. 31.42 nanoseconds. So this is a simple basic problem on this. Now we will consider the wave equation more generally. So we will consider waves in conducting medium. Waves in conducting medium. If you solve the waves equations in this conducting medium, you can apply for any another medium, because conducting medium means it has some conductivity value. So for different mediums, the conductivity differs. So if you substitute the conductivity value so that you can know the properties of the waves in different mediums. So that's why we are solving the properties of waves in more general way, that is in a conducting medium. We know that del square E, the wave equation in a conducting medium, is mu epsilon dou square E by dou T square plus mu sigma dou E by dou T. We know this very well. What I am doing, I am writing the equation phasor notation. So what is phasor notation? So in Maxwell's equations already we discussed this. Phasor notation means put dou by dou T is equal to j omega. Put dou by dou T is equal to j omega. Then what happens? Del square E is equal to mu epsilon dou square by dou T square. Dou by dou T is equal to j omega. Dou square by dou T square is equal to j square omega square. J square is equal to minus 1. So therefore it is minus omega square E plus mu sigma j omega e. Therefore del square E, I am taking all the terms to left hand side, del square E plus omega square into mu epsilon E minus mu sigma j omega E is equal to 0. So simplify further, del square E, what I am taking minus E j omega mu common, minus E j omega mu common. So from this term, what is the remaining thing? I am taking E common, omega common, j common, mu common, minus also common. So the only thing remain is sigma plus, what is the remaining thing? What is it from this term? From this term, I didn't take j. Here there is no j. So this is here I am writing plus minus j, because this is minus j square is minus 1 minus minus plus plus j omega epsilon. Now I am representing this as del square E minus gamma square E is equal to 0, where gamma square is equal to j omega mu into sigma plus j omega epsilon, j omega epsilon, where gamma square is equal to j omega mu into sigma plus j omega epsilon. So this gamma is called propagation constant. Gamma is called propagation constant. What is the unit? Per meter. Unit is propagation constant, and it is per meter. Therefore, del square E minus gamma square E is equal to 0. Similarly, del square H minus gamma square H is equal to 0. So these are the wave equations for conducting medium. Here we are representing with another constant gamma, where gamma square is equal to j omega mu into sigma plus j omega epsilon. These equations are also called as homogeneous vector Helmholtz equations. These equations are also known as homogeneous vector Helmholtz equations, or wave equations simply. Simply wave equations. So we know the more general equations for conducting medium. Del square E minus gamma square E is equal to 0. Del square H minus gamma square H is equal to 0. We know gamma is propagation constant, but gamma we can write like gamma is equal to alpha plus j beta, where alpha is attenuation constant. Where alpha is attenuation constant, beta is phase constant, or it is also known as wave number. Is also known as wave number. So attenuation constant, phase constant. What is the unit? This is Nepper per meter, or dB per meter. What is the unit for this? Radian per meter. Here I am giving the equations for alpha and beta directly. Alpha is equal to omega into square root of mu epsilon by 2 into square root of 1 plus sigma by omega epsilon whole square minus 1. This minus 1 is out of the root and whole root. Similarly, beta is equal to omega into square root of mu epsilon by 2 into square root of 1 plus sigma by omega epsilon whole square plus 1. The only difference for the alpha and beta is minus or plus. So it is advantage if we remember the formulas, particularly useful in solving problems. Here I am not providing the derivations for alpha and beta, which takes a long time. So you may refer any standard textbook for this. And eta. intrinsic impedance. We know that eta is equal to square root of mu by epsilon for free space. But here it is a conducting medium. Conducting medium means it has some sigma value. So more generally, intrinsic impedance is eta is equal to intrinsic impedance that is given by square root of j omega mu by sigma plus j omega epsilon. That is, if you remember this gamma, what is gamma square? J omega mu into gamma square is equal to j omega mu into sigma plus j omega epsilon. So the first term by second term. So like this we can remember. For free space, what is sigma? For free space, sigma is equal to 0. So substitute sigma is equal to 0 here. Then what happens? J omega cancels. What is the remaining thing? Only square root of mu by epsilon. Right. So this is that's why this more general formula for intrinsic impedance of any medium. Intrinsic impedance of any medium. Because suppose this is a dielectric medium. Dielectric medium, what happens? Mu is equal to mu naught into mu r. Epsilon is equal to epsilon into epsilon r. Of course, even though if you have some sigma value, it's not a problem. Lossless dielectric means sigma is always equal to 0. Some lossy dielectric means it has some sigma value also. So for any medium, we can calculate the wave equations properties directly based on these equations. That's why this is more general formulas, alpha, beta, eta. Here, this intrinsic impedance also I can write because this is having a complex values, some magnitude part into some phase value theta n. Magnitude part into some phase value theta n. So, we got the wave equations and some properties, some values also like alpha, beta, gamma. So, in more general, if you solve those two equations, del square u minus gamma square is equal to 0, del square h minus gamma square h is equal to 0, we will get the solutions for e and h. So, more generally, the terms e and h looks like this. Suppose e, for example, e, which is a function of, suppose I am assuming here the wave is propagating in positive z direction plus z direction. So, e is equal to, in terms of z and t only, I will get time harmonic, some magnitude e naught, because here, since it is a conducting medium, it has some alpha value also. Alpha is nothing but attenuation. That is, as the wave is propagating into the medium, the amplitude is attenuated. That's why I am making a term e power minus alpha z, because this term is because of attenuation, some cos omega t minus beta z, cos omega t minus beta z, because the wave is propagating in positive direction. And suppose some Ax component. Suppose then what happens to H of ZT is equal to, H is nothing but E by H is equal to eta. E by H is equal to eta. So eta is nothing but some magnitude and phase. So E naught by magnitude of eta e power minus alpha z cos omega t minus beta z is minus, because theta n comes to numerator, minus theta n a y. Here why I am writing this as a x is, yes, it may be anything, even you may consider a y also, but it is not a z because the wave is propagating in z direction. It don't have AZ component. It may be either AX or AY. Suppose for example here I am taking AX. I am writing here AY. How I am writing here AY is, I know that E cross H always gives propagation direction. E cross H always gives propagation direction. Here the propagation direction is positive Z. That is nothing but AZ. E is AX cross. If H value is what? If H value is what? Then I will get AZ. Obviously, H value is AY. AX cross AY. Then only I will get AZ. That's why I am writing here. For H, I am writing it as AY. So this is another way to write what is the direction of y also. So generally these are two wave equations, wave equations E and H, more general form way, in a more general way how the equations looks like, how the equations looks like a for a conducting medium.